Men's soccer season preview with head coach Gary Hamill. His team is SAC regular season champions from a year ago and advanced all the way to the NCAA region semifinals. Coach, takeaways from, you know, preseason training and scrimmages so far and expectations for this year?
I think the preseason has been very, very good. We're very happy with, we've integrated several new players into the system and, you know, so far, you know, very pleased with it. It's always difficult to judge it until you go up against opposition other than yourselves. But so far, it
feels like this team has, you know, experienced some consistent turnover in players, especially up front with your forwards in the past few years. But you have guys back like Owen Marshall, Pedro Santos, Devin Scully, Nick Viteur that have really played together as a unit for a year and done such great work for you. How crucial are they going to be this year?
Well, they're obviously massively crucial since they're the group that won a championship last year. You know, I mean, take away the cliches, defense wins championships, but I mean, that was the sheer fact of the matter. And, you know, when Owen's your leading goal scorer from center back position, then obviously in the offseason, there was an issue with the forwards, which we have addressed. We brought in several key guys that to add to that defensive unit, and hopefully it'll be more of a well-rounded.
And have to think Alexei Janic coming back in goal. It's safe to say we can pencil him in as your starter after such a great year in his first season.
Yeah, I think you could go ahead and pencil him in. I mean, that's for sure. He had a heck of a year. You know, he's a great goalkeeper. I think, too, he's a great personality around and a great character and person. So that helps. So you have the solid base there with the four or five guys coming back for their COVID year, so to speak. And, you know, they've now been together 4 or 5 years, and that's going to be critical.
And we'll switch back to up front, your forward play. You talked about that just briefly a second ago there, but anybody you're expecting to kind of break out up front in terms of a goal scoring perspective? And is that something, you know, you're going to have to figure out maybe in the first few games of the season before you get to conference play?
Well, I think what we added was two or three individuals that can score goals. I mean, that was the main target in the offseason for obvious reasons. You know, I think young Pablo will do very well. He's a true freshman, and I think he'll just need a few games to get settled in. He's been very impressive in training, as has, you know, a couple of junior college transfers. I think we went with a little bit more experience this year than just true freshmen, mainly to get a whole group together. You know, two new central midfields, which was an area of concern for us last year. Obviously, it's the engine. And so far, the front four, front five, offensively going forward, have been very good in preseason. And, you know, now it's just a matter of getting them, you know, their feet wet and bloodied up and into real games. And what better way to start it than Rollins?
Headed into year 32 now. This team has accomplished so many things in your time here. Numerous SAC titles, region titles, a national title back in 2016. Is that something that you speak about? Is that part of your messages to your team when you speak to your team? Is that the expectation? Or is that something that's really not talked about and the approach is more day by day?
I think the approach is more day by day. I think, you know, the older guys know it. And they've heard me say it. We don't come here to win games. We come to win championships. And I think the history of the program speaks for itself. And, you know, I don't think any of us would judge a season without a trophy as a successful season. I mean, that's just where we're at. And after 30-odd years, I mean, that's what we've built and created. So, no, I think there's a quiet expectation there that that's the, you know, the standard that we've set, and it is.
Lastly, I have to imagine the landscape, you know, of college athletics and college soccer has changed just a little bit in 30-plus seasons. How have you had to change with that and adapt and evolve as a coach?
You know, it's the first time somebody's asked me that question in 20-odd years. It's difficult to do. I think having the ability to understand the generational changes, the changes in the sport. I mean, our sport is very, very different today than what it was 20 years ago, not just on a collegiate level, but on a global level. And I think having the ability and the willingness to listen, understand, and change with the generation and how the sport is played has helped me. There's still some old school ways in there that, you know, but it has changed massively on a global level.
Men's soccer head coach Gary Hamill. Coach, thank you so much for your time.